Line of Buddhism. By the end of the 12th century CE, Buddhism had started vanishing in India or becoming extinct in India. Children, as I already told you, that Buddhism, it was inspired by the spirit of reform. It wanted to remove all the evils which were in Hinduism. But slowly what happened, these evils, it started entering into the Buddhist religion. So, slowly what happened, this Buddhism, it became a victim of the evils of Brahmanism, okay, and against which it had already fought initially. So, in short, in the very beginning, this religion was against many evils, but afterwards, these evils only started entering into Buddhism. This was one reason why this religion started declining. Next, you see slowly what happened. The Buddhist monks, they separated themselves from the common people. Okay, earlier they used to preach in Prakrit language and Pali, but slowly they shifted on to Sanskrit. And Sanskrit language, it was the language of the educated people, and the common people, they were not able to understand it. That was one more reason that the people, they started losing their interest in this religion. Slowly what happened, the monks, they started practicing idol worship. And then as a result, they also started receiving many material offerings from the devotees. And the rich people, they started offering many things to the monks, or many riches to expensive things, or the money to the monks, and they also generously gave the royal grants, which made the lives of the monk very comfortable and luxury. Okay, now by the 7th century, the Buddhist monasteries, they became the centers of corrupt practices, because they received a lot of money also, and they started living a very luxurious life. Okay, so all these things, it was against Buddhism or what Mahatma Buddha preached. So all these evils, they started entering the Buddhist religion. And slowly what happened, the monasteries, they received enormous wealth. And secondly, what happened, even the women, they were allowed to become a member of the Sangha. So slowly, with money and women in the monasteries, it led to further degeneration. Degeneration means making the state more worse. Okay. Then, as I already told you, that the monasteries, they started receiving enormous money. So they became very rich. And as a result, they became special targets of the invaders' greed, or the people, those who attacked India, and all the rulers, the invaders and all, they attacked the monasteries and they destroyed it because it had a lot of wealth. So in order to acquire the wealth, they destroyed the monastery. This was one more reason why Buddhism became declining, or it started declining. Then one more reason which led to the decline of Buddhism was reform in the Hindu religion. The Hindu religion, it started many reforms in itself, and then again the people, they started moving towards the Hindu religion, and again it started becoming popular. So these were the reasons which led to the decline of Buddhism. Children, the last topic of our chapter is comparative study between Jainism and Buddhism. Now you see, children, the followers of both the religion, they laid a lot of importance on leading a very strict life. Okay, some of them, or some of the rules and regulation of both of them, they were strict. Now both the religions, they were against the Vedas. Okay, and they were also against animal sacrifices. So in short, these two were against the Vedic society, or the Brahmanical orthodoxy. Okay. Then, secondly, what is there? That as compared to Jainism, Buddhism, it was moderate towards the non-violence. Or in other words, we can say that in Jainism, non-violence, it was practiced very strictly. But in Buddhism, it was moderate. It was not very strict. Okay. Then, Buddhism, it also laid more stress on middle life. Okay. Although Jainism, it laid more importance on extreme austerity. It means extreme strict rules they were followed. Although in Buddhism, it was moderate, not very strict. Okay. Now, the members of both the religions, you know that both the religions, they accepted the people of the low caste, okay? Both of them, they welcomed the people to join this, the people of the low caste to join this religion. But they did not start anything or they did not do anything to abolish the caste system, okay? Neither they started any powerful struggle against the caste system or to remove the caste system and untouchability. Okay. And moreover, both the religions, they challenged the superiority of the Brahmins. They were against the Brahmins. Okay. Now, as I already, we have learned that Mahatma Buddha, he was silent. He did not speak anything regarding the existence of God. But Mahavira, he did not believe in the existence of God. Okay, Jainism, as we have already studied, that it laid much importance on heart penance, although in Buddhism it was moderate in all the aspects. Okay, it was not very strict in all the aspects. But in short, we can say both Jainism and Buddhism, they were the reform movements. They wanted to remove the evils from the Hindu religion. So they acted as reform movements and they were started in order to reform or remove the evils from the Hindu religion. This we come to the end of this chapter. Okay.